Round and round and round we go, like another visual music, the lighthouse. The lighthouse in the village, the field sea air, my eyes staring at it slowly. Or the lighthouse out at sea, on a rock, that feels much more intensely as waves crash violently over it, and no mere sea air but turbulent winds do shake its soul. This fan is a lighthouse. One that moves as a crescent instead of a circle. The light it shines is a beam of fragrant air that cuts through the dark.
guess many people think differently, but when I listen to music, I enjoy hearing a bit of raw sound. I therefore want to put forward the case for noise. Genuine old hiss, interference, wind and grind. The full mechanics of the recording process captured in all their glory. Surely, I'm not the only person to be tired of the compulsive obsession with perfect audio hygiene that seems to predominate in this industry. In fact, there seems to be a Victorian prudishness which is extended toward anything remotely dirty within the audio spectrum. The natural world is full of interference and unintended reverberation. But when it comes to the recording environment, value judgments are made almost exclusively in relation to this clinical intolerance of dirty old noise. These high expectations of sound quality exude vast areas of music from ever being critically reviewed, and I find this scrutinizing of musical potential infuriating. It also seems pretty unfair for the home recordist, who is the most likely to indulge in these low-cost, noisy antics. We should celebrate the possibilities of noise, distortion, and accidental sound captured by the recording process, rather than trying to eradicate them.
They come.